And with that, I'd like to invite a critical partner who shares this vision for IT. Please join me in welcoming Vice President Product Marketing for SAP, Dan Lahl.
Good morning, Dr. T. How are you?
Good morning, Dan.
Well, we're in Tennessee, so I thought, you know, if the interview doesn't go well, then we can break out something else, but that's for you.
Do you have glasses? Can we get glasses?
Who needs cups?
Yeah.
Who needs glass?
Thanks. You're welcome anytime. You can come back tomorrow. You can...
Okay. And normally I say SUSE, you know, or SUSE, oh. But if we have some of that, maybe it's SUSE.
You're forgiven.
Okay, so. So there you go. Okay.
So you're not only coming with that, you're also coming with a couple of videos showing some of the recent customer stories and great things that you've done, right?
Yeah, let's take a look at those. We have some great customers around the world. We're going to take a look at two different customers that are utilizing SAP and SUSE together. So let's go to the video.
The systems is fully committed to deliver tangible business value to our customers, and for sure they can benefit of our experience. We are one of the largest SAP hosting providers worldwide, and we support 7 million users, as well as more than 800 terabyte HANA databases. More than 4,000 experts worldwide ensure that we can deliver innovative SAP end-to-end services and solutions in time, in quality, to over 600 customers worldwide.
IT systems supporting our customers during their journey into the digital transformation, together with the partner SUSE, where we are also make use of the SUSE frameworks like SUSE CAS or Ceph's cluster to ensure similar reliability in these frameworks as we know it from our traditional SAP host. We run today, based on SUSE Linux Enterprise Server, the largest HANA systems globally, up to 36 terabytes for one single database systems with a reliability just as the traditional databases we know 20 years ago. And this is really something what makes us proud.
T-Systems is committed to deliver in-quality services based on our zero outage methodology. In that regard, we highly appreciate the long-term partnership that we have with SUSE for years, because they allow us to deliver in-time, in-quality services seamlessly integrated to our customers.
We support this, giving our customers a cloud foundation where they can deploy their applications according to their needs, closely connected with their SAP systems we are running for them with no latency and high reliability. For T-Systems, SUSE is our kind of open.
Symmetry, our focus is on SAP technology, whether that's from a consulting standpoint or from a cloud hosting perspective. We rely on SUSE and HPE to provide us with performance, stability, scalability, reliability. Symmetry's customers tend to come to us when they're looking for SMEs in the SAP technical space. They're looking for a service provider and a cloud provider that can offer them the technical expertise, the ability to care and feed their most mission-critical systems, and they're looking for a stable, high-touch cloud hosting environment. Our cloud is purpose-built for SAP workloads. That is our focus. It has been and it will be into the future. As an example of one of our more successful implementations slash migrations to our cloud, we worked with New England Biolabs. We have a long-standing relationship with New England Biolabs providing SAP technical managed services, and when it came time for them to find a cloud hosting provider, it was a natural fit. HPE and SUSE gave us the capability to give them the high compute platform that they were looking for, something that they could run their mission critical business on. The deployment was very successful. Subsequent S/4HANA upgrade, also a highly successful project that again was facilitated due in large part to the scalable platform that we deployed them on. We knew exactly how to care for and feed these mission critical systems and these SAP landscapes. We had the expertise to build and deploy our own proprietary cloud hosting environment with the help of HPE. We moved into that space primarily to give our customers a better hosting experience. And that early hosting effort grew into what is now our cloud today. Layer SUSE Linux Enterprise Server as our operating system of choice on top of that, and you get a very natural, high-performing platform tailor-made for SAP workloads. At Symmetry, we realized that the cloud dynamic is changing. What cloud was 5 years ago isn't what it is today. What it is today isn't what it will be 3 years from where we stand. HPE and SUSE position us to grow into that space and into the demands of our customers. We feel confident that we've chosen the right technology partners to position us for the future.
All right.
So Thomas, those are just great examples of SUSE and SAP working together with our partners to help customers move to the cloud with their applications. And you guys are a key component of that. And I'll also add that I'm happy that Symmetry wasn't talking about Theranos. They were talking about Biolabs. So that's a good thing.
That's way better.
Nobody gets that one, okay, because they haven't seen The Inventor on HBO. Watch that movie. It's amazing.
So, yeah, that's great examples. Can you tell me and tell us a bit more about what's the general philosophy of SAP to help customers achieve their transformation and grow their business? How do you approach that today compared to maybe
years back? We've worked together for over 20 years, but SAP is a 46-year-old company. We're historically an applications ERP company, and we've kind of morphed into what we call an intelligent enterprise company. So we're offering not just the applications, whether that be on-premise or cloud, but also providing the digital platform with HANA and other capabilities, and then intelligent technologies like machine learning, AI, that you talked about, blockchain and IoT and other technologies there in the middle to help customers deliver applications, run applications on-premise in the cloud, but also do digital transformation in that same context.
And we discussed that yesterday night, and you mentioned something that was quite fascinating to me, is that it's not about providing just solution, but you go to the customers, you've got innovation or co-creation type of labs. How does it work?
Yeah. So in addition to offering our kind of our classic application suites, we have something that we use for helping customers in their digital transformation journey. So we found digital transformation is a really big thing for most customers. They don't know how to get started. So what we talk to them about is, why don't we just start a project at a time? Yeah. So let's do a design thinking exercise where you come in, bring your line of business people, bring your IT people, bring an executive sponsor and say, this is where we want to digitally transform in this specific area.
Yeah.
Let's put a bunch of stickies on the board. Let's throw a bunch of ideas out there. Let's then start building a prototype right there in the session that we use an SAP product called Build to do that. And then we apply different technologies against that SAP design session that we did with the customer, whether it be blockchain, IoT, machine learning, database, data movement, whatever it is. We do that in the cloud. We spin up a project with them together. 6 to 8 weeks, we try and get to minimal viable product. And then if it works, then we move forward on that project. So their digital Very transformation nice. Doesn't have to all come as one big lump sum. Yeah. It can come as kind of chewable bites.
And that's a transformation that makes sense for them.
Exactly, and, exactly, for each customer.
Yeah. So the theme of SUSECON 2019 is my kind of open. And I know we've been working together for a long time on many different open source projects, but I wanted to get from you your own definition of my kind of open. What is it for you and for SAP?
Yeah, well, a couple of years ago, if you said my kind of open to SAP, it would be my kind of closed. Yeah. You know, we were a walled garden, okay, and not invented here. But we have really done a 180. And as you know, Thomas, you serve on the board of Cloud Foundry Foundation with SAP. We actually helped put the Cloud Foundry Foundation together with Pivotal and the other companies. And so we're actually the second largest contributor to the Cloud Foundry Foundation. We just don't consume the Cloud Foundry technology that gives us multi-cloud, but we're the second largest contributor. And we worked with you and with IBM on what you talked about earlier, on the containerization of Cloud Foundry, giving that developer experience inside a container, deployed anywhere. That's really awesome. IBM doing the work of pulling out Bosch and replacing Kubernetes as the orchestration engine. Our component in that was to build the service broker API, so you can have services talk to clouds, within clouds, between clouds, so you have the services talking together. So a great project.
On the Cloud Foundry side. I'm also seeing a lot more contributions from SAP on the Kubernetes side as well.
That's right.
And you've got a very cool project called Gardener.
We have this really cool project called Gardener. What we found as we were implementing our services and delivering them to our customers in Kubernetes is that Kubernetes is awesome, but it's tough to scale clusters. And so we put together this open source project called Gardener, that allows you to scale up to thousands of Kubernetes clusters. And we have some technologies and some HA and disaster recovery capabilities built into the product. And we have put that forward to CNCF, Cloud Native Compute Foundation, as a project.
Yeah.
And so that's pretty exciting with them.
And I have a lot of examples of open source projects that you're doing from contributing to Knative, so Function as a Service, Schema, Kubeless. There's one that I need to ask you, and I'm going to try to put a little bit of context around that because, well, so what's your plan for open sourcing HANA? Okay.
So I think if we get down halfway through this bottle, we can get on the phone with Hasso Plattner and see if he's open to that
idea. We go back to Germany and...
That's right.
All right. So 2020.
2020. Yeah.
So let's go back to customers, because I know that you're also customer obsessed inside SAP, right? I want to get your perspective on what are the main challenges that your key customers are facing today, if there's anything specific that they are telling you, if you have examples of how you solve that with them.
Yeah, so I think it's kind of the following that theme of doing digital transformation a project at a time on what's most important to you. So I'll give you two examples. One is the San Francisco 49ers. They just built a new stadium a couple of years ago, and they wanted to be the best venue for sporting events in the world. And so what they did is they put together an integrated system that tracks real-time information coming in a bunch of different touch points for people utilizing the park, whether that be parking systems, admission systems, concession systems, souvenir systems, gating systems. They're tracking in real time what's happening around Levi Stadium in Santa Clara, and they're making real time decisions. Do we need to direct people to a different gate? Do we need to put more people on a gate that's getting crowded? Do we need to push parking in a different way? They can make real-time decisions in the context of what they're doing during game day in real time. And they only have 10 opportunities to do this. That's the number of games the 49ers play in.
Yeah, they have to get it right.
So it's massive. And again, that was a design thinking process that we went through with the 49ers to do that.
Nice.
The second example is Bumblebee Seafood. So if you're a Bumblebee tuna fan, they're going to be putting on every can of tuna a QR code that you can scan, and it will tell you exactly where that tuna was caught, what village, what are the sustainable things they're doing to track that. And you can track using blockchain technology on tuna, believe it or not, blockchain technology to track from the line to the table and give you a seamless experience so you know that you're buying a fair trade.
That's pretty useful, because I've got a small anecdote from a SUSE executive, I will not name him or her, who got food poisoning with tuna in a restaurant. So it would have helped, but no names.
Well, not Bumblebee, I hope. I hope it's some other brand.
Yeah.
But it was in Amsterdam. But what a great application of technology to be able to track that you're guaranteed fair trade tuna all the way through the system,
really nice.
From line to table.
Okay, well, I think one last thing before we leave is that I know there's one more video coming, and I've seen it, and I'm not really happy because you stole the SUSE band to do a cool SAP video.
Yeah, we actually took your video crew,
who
was awesome, by the way, and we took your band, and we actually came up with a whole new song. We moved them over to Waldorf, and it's not my style of song, but some people will relate to it, but it's a brand new song that we put together, and they didn't allow me in the video because I'm not smart enough. So you'll see that. Let's roll the video.
Let's roll the video, and let's go and drink that together.
Great.
Thanks,
we'll
Dan.
Open that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Your enterprise, we're proving all your lies.